Hello, in this presentation, we will provide you with information regarding the John Laurie Boulevard Northwest Restoration and Reconstruction Project from Shaganapi Trail to 14th Street. I'm Ronnie Davis, Communications Analyst at the City of Calgary with Transportation Infrastructure. Adrian Tanase will be presenting this project today as he is the City of Calgary Project Manager and Senior Transportation Engineer with Transportation Infrastructure. Also presenting today, we are joined by Reese Bishop, who is the Project Manager with the consultant team at Jacobs Engineering Group. To introduce this project, I will turn it over to Adrian.
Thanks, Ronnie. As Ronnie mentioned, my name is Adrian Tanase. I'm a Senior Transportation Engineer with the City of Calgary Transportation Infrastructure and the project manager for this project. On this slide, you'll see the project location and an overview of the work undertaken. This project, within this approximately 4.5 kilometer zone, is primarily a restoration and reconstruction of the road surface and pavement structure. It extends from Shaganapi Trail on the top left of this plan to east of 14th Street on the bottom right of this plan. The majority of the project length was rehabilitated previously in 1997. The segments closer to Shaganapi Trail were paved in 2009 as part of the Shaganapi Trail Intersection Improvements Project. This project will improve roadway operations, safety characteristics, surface structure durability, and rideability. I'm going to go over the scope of work briefly before turning over to Reese to go through in more detail. The scope of work for this project is depicted in the overall plan with a legend at the bottom showing the type of work, which will consist of the following: mill and overlay for the majority of the project, shown in dark blue. There'll be various depths of milling and paving depending on the severity and condition of the existing pavement. Full intersection reconstruction at Brisbane Drive, shown in yellow. Localized sections of the roadway show excessive distress, including frost heave, that have affected pavement performance near the intersection with Brisbane Drive. For this reason, at this intersection, full depth pavement reconstruction is required. Improved access to No-Sill Park at Brisbane Drive, shown in yellow, as part of Brisbane Drive intersection reconstruction. This work will consist of realigning the access to the parking lot by providing an access that will line up with the intersection lading and south leg of the intersection. High tension cable barriers, shown in light blue. The barriers will be installed in the roadway landscape median between the intersections. Upgrades of a few existing pathways, shown in light brown. There will be a few sections of pathway widening at 19th Street and 14th Street. Various concrete work and landscaping, shown in gray and green respectively. Other various and localized work will be pre-installation of traffic signals underground infrastructure at three intersections, Brisbane Drive, Charleswood Drive, and 19th Street. The signals underground infrastructure is being installed as part of this project to reduce future costs and impacts to the traveling public. Signals will be installed when warranted in the future after a detailed analysis is completed. Various localized surface stormwater infrastructure and streetlights repairs. Using this opportunity, a few streetlights and any surface stormwater infrastructure such as catch basins, manholes, valve tops, damaged or in poor condition will be replaced. With that, I'll hand it over to Reese from Jacobs to go through some details of the project.
Thanks, Adrian. As Ronnie and Adrian mentioned, my name is Reese Bishop, and I am the project manager with Jacobs working with the city on this project. As Adrian mentioned, I will go through the scope of the project in a bit more detail, including some larger images so it's easier to see the primary work being completed. As many of you will know, the existing condition of this section of John Laurie Boulevard is in poor condition, as seen in the photos on the slide. The section of roadway is experiencing severe fatigue cracking, rutting at the intersections and along John Laurie Boulevard, and transverse and longitudinal cracking along the corridor. Further, the underlying soil conditions at the Brisbane Drive intersection is resulting in frost heaving of the existing pavement. It is for these reasons that this section of John Laurie Boulevard is being rehabbed as part of this project. At the Shaganapi Trail and John Laurie Boulevard intersection, the existing pavement will receive mill and inlay of 80 to 100 millimeters in depth to the limits shown on the image, north, south, and west of the intersection. This milling will help repair both cracking and rutting in the existing pavement. Rehab of the Brenner Drive and John Laurie Boulevard intersection will be completed through mill and inlay of the intersection to south limit shown on the image, as well as the removal and replacement of severely damaged curb and gutter. The intersection will also receive upgraded lighting to improve lighting levels and the safety of the intersection. The largest section of rehab along the project will occur at the Breezepa Drive and John Laurie Boulevard intersection. For those that use this corridor on a regular basis, you will likely know that this section of John Laurie Boulevard is in the worst condition. Due to the existing condition of the pavement and the underlying cause of deterioration, mill inlay was not a suitable option for rehab, unlike the other areas along the project. As a result, the existing intersection and about 200 meters west and east of the intersection will be completely rebuilt with a new upgraded pavement structure and subdrains. To improve pedestrian safety, the eastbound to southbound right turn from John Laurie Boulevard to Breezepa Drive has been redesigned to pull the entrance of vehicles on Breezepa Drive farther away from the pathway crossing south of the intersection. The new smart right turn will slow down vehicles entering Breezepa Drive and provide additional time to see and react to pedestrians in the crosswalk. The entrance to the Many Owls parking lot has been realigned to better align the parking lot entrance with Breezepa Drive. New stormwater infrastructure and upgraded lighting will be installed to match the updated design of the intersection. High-tension cable burial will be installed both west of the intersection towards Brenner Drive and east towards Charleswood Drive. Rehab of the Charleswood Drive and John Laurie Boulevard intersection will be completed through mill and inlay at the intersection to the south limit shown on the image, as well as the removal and replacement of severely damaged curb and gutter within the intersection. The intersection will also receive upgraded lighting to improve the lighting levels and the safety of the intersection. High-tension cable burial will be installed west towards Breezepa Drive and east towards 19th Street. Rehab of the 19th Street and John Laurie Boulevard intersection will be completed through mill and inlay of the intersection to the south limit shown on the image, and the removal and replacement of severely damaged curb and gutter. The intersection will also receive upgraded lighting to improve the lighting levels and safety of the intersection. Small pathway connections will be installed between the existing pathway south of the intersection and the parking lot entrances west and east side of the intersection. A high-tension cable burial will be installed both west towards Charleswood Drive and east towards 14th Street. Rehab of the 14th Street and John Laurie Boulevard interchange will be completed through mill and inlay of John Laurie Boulevard and the interchange on and off ramps. The project limit will be approximately 400 meters east of 14th Street along John Laurie Boulevard, where the previous rehab project ended. Minor pathway upgrades include the widening of the pathway in the northwest corner of the interchange and widening of the pathway in the southeast corner, which will allow pathway users to safely bypass pedestrians waiting to cross the 14th Street ramp. Except for a short duration for the rebuilding of the parking lot entrance, the Many Owls parking lot will remain open during construction. Park users would like to avoid the construction area as much as possible. Nose Hill Park users can also utilize other parking lots in the area. Nearby parking lots include 14th Street, north of John Laurie Boulevard, Calgary Winter Club, access from 14th Street, the existing parking lot at 19th Street and John Laurie Boulevard, and the existing parking lot on the east side of Shakopee Trail at Edgemont Boulevard. I will now pass it over to Adrian discuss a little bit more of the project timeline.
Thanks, Reese. In terms of schedule, the detailed design has been completed along with the construction and tender package preparation. The procurement and tender process has started, with the project being issued on the market in order to receive construction bids. Construction award and selection of contractor is expected at the end of April 2021. Construction is scheduled to commence by mid-May 2021, with construction completion planned for October 2021. Various lane closures and speed reductions throughout the construction limits and duration of the project will be expected. As well, there will be delays and traffic impacts for commuters traveling in the area. We would like to thank in advance to commuters and public in the area for their patience during construction of this project. Thank you.
I would like to thank our presenters. Some additional resources we would like to share with you include the project webpage listed on this slide. We encourage you to visit calgary.ca/John Laurie Boulevard for project information and updates. Here, you can also sign up to receive project newsletters, and you can ask the project team questions regarding this project. We will answer frequently asked questions via periodic updates to the project FAQs. Also, please make sure to follow us on social media at YYC Transport and at City of Calgary. We thank you for taking the time to watch this presentation, and we also thank you in advance for your patience throughout the construction period.